James, on the other side of our studio with MediaWatch, good evening to you.
Hi there.
And today, a very somber moment, of course, the 17th anniversary of the 9/11 terror attacks. They've been marked by many people, of course, but some acts of remembrance, it seems, have, fallen short.
Yes, you could say that. Now, many people, of course, took to social media this morning to share their memories, their reflections, their thoughts on September the 11th. But the US president took to Twitter to begin tweeting angrily on a range of subjects, including the fact that he says there was no collusion. He also attacked the Department of Justice and the FBI, and then went on to personally attack the former Attorney General, Eric Holder. Now, he reacted this way on Twitter: "This is not a day for the usual unhinged Trump politics. This is a day to remember the innocent Americans we lost and the brave first responders who gave their lives." A very angry response, but also very controlled and appropriate, I think you'll agree. Now, when Donald Trump finally did address the issue of September the 11th itself, this is what he had to say, and a lot of people felt this was lacking. 17 years since September the 11th and an exclamation mark. A lot of people reacting to this one, unsurprisingly. A lot of presidents would use this day to honour the dead rather than prove they have the ability to count, says this gentleman. This woman says, "So you can tweet long paragraphs about your witch hunt, but that's all you can say about 9/11. There was another tweet a little later on, this one certainly more appropriate, but still very much lacking in any empathy or emotion. It's basically details of what he was going to be doing. After a moment's silence in Washington, they were heading to Shanksville, where, of course, one of the flights came down. And that is where, really, he reached new heights, as far as many people were concerned, of inappropriateness. This is him arriving at the airport, doing a double fist pump. A very strange reaction many people felt when he arrived in Pennsylvania. This is another photograph of the moment as he walked across the tarmac. Melania behind looking appropriate, whereas Donald Trump appears to think he's addressing one of his rallies. Now, there were some people there to greet him in his defence, so he was reacting to them. But yes, bear in mind, this was a memorial service that he was about to attend for those lost on the United Airlines Flight 93, one of the four aircraft that came down that day in 2001. This gentleman taking to Twitter to say he can't even take 9/11 off from being a colossal schmuck. This woman saying, "This is not an exclamation point day. This is not a fist pump day. You might also say it's not a thumbs up kind of a day," but that is what he was captured doing here, right in front of the brand new National Memorial Visitor Centre there in Shanksville, where that aircraft came down. Now, there will be those who say it's unfair to focus on these particular singular moments and comment on them, especially given that his speech was relatively well received. But undoubtedly, he knows he was in the spotlight today, and this appropriate or inappropriate behaviour should really not be happening.
Donald Trump, then, it is fair to say, has a rather difficult history with this, important date for the US.
Very much so, and perhaps people expected him to be even more careful about how he is perceived on this date for that very reason, because there are many things that he has said over the years that people are still upset about. On the day of those terror attacks in 2001, he gave an interview by telephone in which he boasted that his building was now the tallest in New York. That's courtesy of the Twin Towers having come down. Now, as well as being completely inappropriate, it was also untrue. It wasn't even the tallest building. He's also claimed in the past that thousands of Muslims were seen cheering when the Twin Towers fell. And, of course, let's not forget a tweet that he sent out in 2013, just 5 years ago. "I would like to extend my best wishes to all, even the haters and losers, on this special date, September the 11th. Now, if you are in need of a moment of reflection after all of this unpleasantness, the best article to take a look at is this one from the New York Times at 9/11 Memorial. Beautiful images by Gina Moon. She's captured some of the most moving images of today's events. This, an honour guard with a flag that was damaged on the day during those attacks. And this gentleman paying tribute to his fallen friend, a firefighter, Ruben Correa. This article ends with a quote from Nicholas Harros, who lost his mother, Frances, in the attacks. He said, "Please stop using the bones and ashes of our loved ones as props in your political theatre. Their lives, sacrifices and deaths are worth so much more."
Couldn't put it better myself. Now, moving on to, revisiting, in a sense, the cartoon you showed us last night of Serena Williams, and a disgraceful cartoon it was. And it's still causing a whole storm of controversy.
Absolutely. The controversy hasn't blown over, and that's because, really, the newspaper that published it and the cartoonist seem to be revelling in all the attention. Now, Mark Knight is the man who drew that cartoon. You can see it there in the background. He looks pretty smug about the whole thing. He has given an interview. There's a video on the Herald Sun website. It's an Australian newspaper. "I drew her as she is, as an African-American woman." Now, he claims he didn't draw on the racist imagery of the past, which is what a lot of people have claimed. He says it's not about racism, but about her behaviour on the day. He claims the world has gone crazy. He has the full support of the Herald Sun, the newspaper that he works for. This is their front page. "Welcome to PC World." And you see Serena Williams down there in the bottom right-hand corner. Interestingly, they have gone all out in the paper. There are several different articles, all backing him, unsurprisingly. This one, I notice, hasn't got a name on it. It just says "staff writer," says Herald Sun backs Mark Knight's cartoon. Another I'm not sure if that's a statement they're trying to make. Another one is entitled "Knight is about as racist as I am Chinese," which seems an odd way to combat racism. Lots of the News Corp executives have been taking to Twitter to support him. "Australia's finest cartoonist Mark Knight has the strongest support of his colleagues," says Peter Blunden. "It's about bad behaviour, certainly not race. The PC Brigade are way off the mark again." However, it's interesting to note that all of his social media accounts have been shut down. We're not sure whether he's taken them off himself or whether he's been suspended because of all the controversy and people reporting what they view as a racist image.